So good morning, everyone. And this is like a, I think, fifth session we are doing in Delhi. We started somewhere around 5 years ago from the same venue. And it's good to have this conference again. Okay, so let's get into Agile. My topic is, like, do we really get some benefit from Agile, or it is just like another way of making people fool and making some money? So that's the whole idea is. Now, I want to experiment some of the Agile values in this group and see that do we get a benefit from it. So, simple exercise. I think some of the table we have 5-6 people, some are less. So we start with a 5-minute of activity where you just need to do one thing. You introduce yourself on the table and share if you have achieved any benefit from Agile. In last 1 year, 6 months, whatever duration you have been following Agile. And the benefit is not coming from a book or anything. It is something like, have you ever felt it in your way of working? And you can share that in a group, and then we see what we can do with that. That's the one thing. The another thing is you can also share if you have some disappointment with it. That, okay, it is just like the same thing, it is not making any change for me. So I give you a 5 minute, and then I will give you another activity, and hopefully we will converge somewhere. Focus on individual and interaction. Do remember the names of the people who are sitting on your table, and also understand their Agile journey. Okay, your 5 minutes starts now. Okay, guys, thank you. So let's focus on the bigger conversation. Thank you for participation. Now, we will talk about Agile, but before we talk about Agile, how you felt after doing this exercise? Not about Agile, what is your feeling?
Some oneness, we are at some same
place. Connected. And do you think that feeling of connected will help you to achieve more from this conference? Yeah. And that is what we call in Agile individual and interaction. Can we deny the value of individual and interaction? You just felt it. Now, there is a lot of science and theory behind what we did. As soon as we see someone unknown, stranger, we take it as a threat. That this person is here to kill me or something like that. You know, you are always is quite conscious about it. But as soon as you spend some time, you open up an interaction, you start feeling comfortable. Yeah? And when somebody challenges you, now you need to change the table, again the uncomfort comes. Yeah, resistance to change. Oh, what is this, yaar? We already sat with these guys. And then you go again, remain in a hostile environment for a while, as if everybody is your enemy again. And then again, 30 seconds, 60 seconds, you start feeling comfortable. And this helps you to do rest of the things better. And now, we don't need to call waterfall Agile or Kanban or anything, but in general, I think this feeling helps us in doing something better. Yeah. Now, by doing this exercise, you are more or less connected with 35, 40 people indirectly because you met 6 people, they were meeting 6 people, and these new 6 people were meeting another 6 people. So more or less, you have a 2-degree connectivity in the whole room. Yeah. You have something. And that will help us in making some sense of individual interaction. Any comment, observation based on what I felt here? Yeah, go ahead. Okay, great. Yeah, that's a nice idea. Yeah, great. Now let's come to Agile. Okay, so what kind of a benefit? Few people can share what benefit they feel that they are getting from Agile. We have a mic, so yeah, please, one mic here. Yahan pe.
Uh-huh. Second thing is the acceptance of the project or product. And third thing,
haan, voice kafi achhi hai waise.
Okay. Yeah, so I feel the early and fast delivery of the projects, the engagement of the stakeholders throughout the project, so that the stakeholder means the acceptance of the project would be much more than earlier it was. Mm-hmm. So these are the things. And third thing
is... You're observing.
Yep.
You're observing in your work environment, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, great. So yep. What you're observing is that the more stakeholder engagement, helping in better communication, and better issue resolution,
yep,
and sometime better delivery. Great. Anyone else has some sharing? Or risks also can get shared?
Yeah, yeah, I have one risk
also,
as well.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. The major risk we see on the organizations is if the leadership doesn't have agile mindset, then it is very hard to convince them.
Okay, convince them for what?
For being agile.
Okay.
To adopt the agility. Uh-huh. So it is very hard to convince them because they have a mindset of 15, 20 years of exposure, so they don't want to change their mindset.
Okay, great. We will explore this. We will explore this in talk. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Can we go there? Yeah, yeah. So we collect three more, and then I give lecture after that. Yeah. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, what I have observed is we can get feedback quite early,
okay,
from the client as well as from the senior team members. While doing the sprint review, giving a demonstration, we can get feedback from everybody quite early. Whereas in the waterfall, we used to get it in a couple of months.
Yeah? Okay,
in
great.
A 2-week sprint cycle or a 1-week sprint cycle, we can get quite
early. And this is something you're observing in your team,
yes,
and projects.
Yeah.
Great. So
that's
early feedback, continuous
benefit.
Interaction, stakeholder engagement, helping everybody to get involved. And something we saw here, individual and interaction, rather than keep sitting and hoping somebody will give a lecture and then we go. Mm-hmm. Great. Yeah. Thank you. Okay, same table. Okay.
I also want to add that now we are working in a team. We are not working in silos. So we are working as a team.
Okay. So it helps you to create better team engagement because people are more talking,
yeah,
frequently.
Yeah.
Great. Yeah. So incremental thing, I think these two things are covered now. Customer collaboration, incremental and iterative development, and team engagement. Any incremental other value out of these three? Yeah. Maybe we go there and then we come back. Incremental, yeah. And risks also incremental risks. Two more and then we take something, yeah.
Okay, so beauty of Agile is that it's also talked about, it's very proactive in nature. It's talked about inspect and adapt and how to respond changes and how we welcome frequent changes. It's
great. So that is something you are writing. I think I changed the track now. You can give the phone. Now somebody is saying that, yeah, it's all good, but you know, in my company, more or less we are doing the same thing, but we are following Agile now. Anybody in that group? Yeah, okay, there are few. Anybody would like to share the story ki now there are people saying Agile, but we are still in the same mess. Yeah. Maybe Ramita, you give to someone, yeah, there and here. That the darker side of Agile also.
So I think my observation has been that, Agile is the word that people use at their own convenience.
Okay.
My team started saying that we are really into Agile, and even our management said that we are going Agile way. But when it comes to the meetings, we are still having those long hourly meetings. When it comes to the customer says, forget about Agile, you give me requirements, I'll sign it off completely. And then I'll, talk to you, what is it that you're developing. My personal experience has been, we started off a project assuming that we can really adopt Agile and, do it that way. In the second sprint, when we were doing demos, customer came, looking at the demo, he said, oh, is it this something that I really asked for? Forget about it. You take 18 months, and we really took 18 months to really capture the requirements, get it signed off, and then now we are really developing it. So it's very difficult to change the mindset of the customers, your own organizational culture, which has really impacted in a bad way.
Thank you. One more. I think we come there. And one criticism, or I would say that no value coming. And then we come there. Yeah. So two more. Go ahead.
So a few challenges what we faced in Agile is that sometimes we conduct Agile in a very customized manner as per the customer expectations and senior management mindset. So what I feel that many of times we are following Agile sprint scrums only for testing of bugs, something like that. Many of times what we feel that the biggest challenge is that these days projects are very fixed, big projects and very fixed timelines. So we have to deliver the project as per the customer timeline is really very challenging.
Great. So means that customer, in your scenario, what I am sensing is customer is saying do Agile, but I won't pay for it. Yeah, I will pay some fixed amount and still keep changing the Agile way. Okay, maybe we give to final this table and then we take the conversation forward. Yeah. The final one, yeah. And then I know many of you wanted to share. You can tweet about it. Yeah, go ahead.
All right. So when we talk Agile, we talk self-sustaining and self-motivated teams.
Okay.
So one of the experiments that I heard from one of the leaders in my organization was that he kind of tried to back off a little bit from the team, trying to gauge how they take the work as they move forward. But the team has been in the system for quite a long time, so there is a factor of complacency that kicks in. And we ended up getting into a complete mess. So there were escalations, there were certain things. So this leader got really scared. He tried, he was courageous to give it a try. However, when this all mess happened, he had to jump in, he had to take care of the chaos. And now he is kind of a little skeptical to try that kind of an experimentation again. So he tends to jump in, he tends to help his team. So that's not really in the spirit of creating self-sustaining and self-motivated teams.
Thank you. So now I present three ideas, and some of guys who have attended my Agile coaching class may find some repeat of ideas. But I present three ideas which can probably help us in see how can we really get benefit from Agile, or why some organization can take value but others are not. So there is always a challenge, and let's explore this idea in say next 10-15 minutes, and we see where we go. Now, if you go 10 years ago, when something goes wrong, what frequently you hear your manager asking for? Say defect happened or something goes wrong in your project. What do you hear your manager, seniors asking?
RCA.
Maybe that's still matured. Before RCA, it was, who did this? So the who was important, you know? The who is the culprit? I need to really talk to him. Yeah. That's the focus. So what we used to do, when something goes wrong, we need to find somebody to blame for. Okay? Because of him, this happened. Now what do you do next? That is not a concern. Because of him, this happened. That's the thing. Now gradually this is RCA and all those stuff. But initially the whole thing was, let's blame the people. Then some management guru came and then said, no, people are already doing great work. When something happens, it is not because of people. Then it is because of a process. Okay, let's blame the process then. And when next time, whenever goes wrong, something goes wrong, your project manager says, let's understand the process of doing it. And some of you who worked in a quality department may always get called when something is not working, and you need someone to blame or excuse, you know. There's a process gap, what do we do? Everybody is great, and then the RCA and all those stuff starts coming in. So we are done with blaming people, we become little mature, then we start blaming the process. Now when we started blaming the process, then what is the result? You know, you are doing waterfall, ultimately, and you should go to Agile. Change the process, improve the process, your life will be better. Yeah? Anybody been through that journey? Now, assuming you change the process, still there is a problem, then what do you do? Who to blame? There are two, three selling. Eh? One is change the process again. Okay, this is not working, you need Agile, you need Kanban, you need DevOps, or you need something. But keep moving, someday your problem will get solved. Some will say, no, process is already great. Now, what is not working? Your culture is a problem. You know, your company culture is the mess. Now, what do? Blame the culture. Now, how do you do change about it? You don't know. Now, till the time individuals, organizations will keep finding somebody to blame for, change will not happen. When the change can happen? When you see and say, okay, I am responsible to fix it. Rather than I am responsible to find somebody to blame to. And I feel, my personal experience, there is no theory, no model. As a human being, we are still looking for something to blame. Somebody make us, teach us that don't blame someone. Then we blame process, then we blame culture, then we may blame mindset, or sometime we may start blaming management, leader, or something. But the change will not happen till the time you say, okay, this is it. I need to do something about it. Now, you can change the process. If you have been following waterfall has a problem, you can change the process. Who stops you rather than blaming it? You can change the way of working rather than looking for a label to change it. And once you do that change, the result will start coming in. So if my team is start enjoying as soon as I give them a freedom, I can change it. rather than blaming it to Agile, I say this approach is not working. I need to do something else here. And if I do that, I get the result. But if I just find, okay, this Agile has a problem, now we need to do something else. Then I found something to blame to. Okay, I stop here. So this is the first idea. Any comment or observation on it? Does this make sense? Okay, there is a comment. We need a mic here, yeah. I do think mic or me, no?
Hello, yeah. My name is Manish, and I'm working for Thales. So what I feel that, as you said, that we start blaming with people, then process, then culture, and then one more thing, mindset. So the thing is, we all, as an agile practitioner, we often talk about mindset, culture, but nobody wants to work on it. So when you want to change the culture, you have to change the habits. So if I want to wake up early in the morning, I have to go to bed early also. So at the, if you want to both happen, we want to go too late to the bed and wake up early, then it wouldn't be as possible. So you have to change your habits. And organization doesn't want to change the habit.
Good,
managers
good.
Do not want to command and control because it's part of culture. So culture change requires years.
So good. So rather than talking about here and there, we can do something about it. Great. So I take this thread forward and let's build that because I'm also a little aware of the time. Though I think we are enjoying the conversation, dialogue, rather than a talk. So I take this thing forward, and I keep teaching this concept multiple times, that if you want to change from one stage to another stage, I represent it in the form of one stage to another stage. So it's like this, that right now you are not delivering well. Now, why are we going agile? Maybe the problem is we have a high defect. Teams are not happy. Customers are not happy, so everybody is sad or everybody is stressed. And what do we want? We want to reach to a stage where people are enjoying, they are delivering on time, and we make maximum value out of our time and resource available. That's it. That's what we want to do. Yeah. So we have a stage A where we are doing something, but we are looking for some stage B where we can get better thing. Now, what do we do? If I take this example at a personal level, and you may realize that I am not getting liked by people, or I want to do something so that people start liking me. And your current thing is that people don't like you, they don't want to hang around with you because you behave in that way, and you want to change your style of behaving so that they start liking you. Yeah. So you focus on, right now I'm doing waterfall, or in a case of like, I don't listen. Whenever somebody comes, I start speaking. I don't spend time. I don't show interest in it. When I start listening them, they will start liking me. That is some consultant told me. Then I say, okay, I will start smiling and listening people. What will happen? This should produce better result. Yeah, so from waterfall to agile should produce a better result. You are doing something different. Now, there is a deeper part of it. Why I don't listen to people? So there could be, this is my doing. But there could be feeling and thinking part which makes me do this. Make sense? So if I feel frustrated with people, and if I feel that I am the smartest person on this earth, then what will happen? I will not listen. And if I keep feeling same, frustrated, and I am the smartest person on the earth, and I give people smile and try to listen, what will happen? My smile and appreciation will not survive for long. Some point in time, I will end up getting frustrated that, okay, I have listened to you well, now let me speak. Some point in time it will come, once in a while, and people say, what happened to this guy? He was showing so hello, and now immediately he behaved differently. People will identify it. Yeah? So in order to really influence people, I need to believe that people are good. I need to feel good about them. I need to focus on that. I want to learn from them. There is something to teach me. And if that behavior starts coming in, if that feeling and thinking starts coming in, it will influence my behavior and the result. Now, same, let's dig into agile world. So I am getting lots of defect. My stakeholders are not happy. My people are not happy. Because I am following waterfall, let me follow Scrum. Now, what is deeper there? Deeper is, I believe people will waste time till the time I don't monitor. I believe that the reward and recognition should be critically managed. My people believe in competition, and I also promote competition. That guy is doing better than you. Why you can't do it? So if I keep that competition in my head, in an organization as a feeling, and I have all the structure of controlling and influencing people and not trusting them, and I start doing Scrum, then it will be the same exercise. My thinking feeling is still the old, but my behavior is unnaturally collaborate people, go into a daily Scrum. I want you to collaborate, and I'm sitting here and checking what is happening there. What will happen? So, benefits may not come. Again, the benefits are not coming because of Agile. Benefits are coming because of what you are doing. I keep giving an example of weight loss industry. You know, you can buy any diet plan, you can buy any pill, but nobody can help you in losing your weight. Nobody can do that. No exercise can do that. They can guide you, but finally you can do it. The day you decide I have to do it, you can do it. Because a lot of thinking, feeling goes there. It is not only just doing, oh, I joined the gym, now I will be better. No, you won't be. And that is why I keep giving this example that 80 to 90% of the gym members, they join for 1 year, and that's why the gym owner sells 1 year membership in a cheaper rate than a monthly membership, because they know hardly person will come for 1 month. Hardly. And if you end up asking, okay, how many membership you have and how can you survive in such a small fee? He says, don't worry, sir, 90% people are not coming. And that is how we survive. They will come once in a while. And the same thing is something in our agile world. So what you said, and overall, I think why I'm bringing this point is, you own your thinking and feeling. No consultant can change your thinking and feeling. No consultant can change company's feeling and feeling. And no consultant can change your own feeling and thinking. So you have to, if you want to. And you can only do it when you really care for it. Else, you won't move there, and Agile won't produce any benefit. Now, sometimes as a consultant, we sell Agile like anything, like the weight loss industry, you know, Sona belt. You wait till there is belt, and everything will be good. So it doesn't work. Yeah, people buy it. And I can also give a simple prescription. You know, I have such a great prescription which will work for all of you, and it will give you great health. What is the prescription? Go for a walk in the morning, 1 hour. Go for a walk in the evening, 1 hour. And don't eat sugar and oil. Take it. This is Agile prescription. Follow. So actually, many prescriptions are very easy. The whole game is execution. Yeah? And if the consultant keeps giving, oh, I have such a unique recipe which can make your problem goes away like anything. But who has to work on that as a recipe? If the other person has to work, it depends upon who takes what from it. Great. We have some time for comments or questions. If there are any, I think that is what I wanted to bring. So my idea is definitely Agile can help, depending upon what do we do with it, how do we feel and think about it, and how much ownership we take for making it successful rather than finding something to blame to. Yeah. Some comments, questions. Then after that, bring it here. Yeah, go to there and to him, he's standing. 5 minutes, that's the scheduled time we have. And then
hi. So yeah. The biggest challenge which I feel, whether be it a waterfall or agile, was like management is ready to do the process changes and everything. But when it comes to meeting the forecast, they are not ready to take the hit. So they want all the processes to be changed, team methodologies to be changed. But when it comes to the quarterly or the monthly review, they directly blame. So they are not able to take the financial hit for the change. That is the biggest challenge like I am facing in waterfall, be it Agile.
Great. So what my perception is, there are two things if as an Agile influencer, as a practitioner, we are looking for. We can't just go with, okay, they need to do it. If I am there and I have to advise, I may need to understand why there is a resistance. There could be a business model, there could be a reasons for them not to do it. So not necessarily all changes are needed. We need to understand Because see, if my business is my client billing is based on those things, and the company's survival depends on that, then company may want to hold those processes and those way of working. At the same time, I may want to make them aware what we lose by doing it. If by doing this, I am losing the people's trust in experimentation. If I'm losing people's trust in collaboration and they want to save themselves all the time and they start focusing on my job should not get impacted, I do all the thing. If something goes wrong, there should be somebody else to blame too. So if it creates a blame culture, ultimately company suffers. Now, I'm not hoping that everybody can explain to all the world, but that is something I would do if I have to influence someone. And if I take his point, you know, personally, it is not that easy to tell everyone, let's guys self-organize and enjoy. I don't believe that. And I changed this over the last 20 years of my own experimentation. People are at a very different stage of their sense of responsibility. And I believe the responsibility and freedom should be balanced all the time. If you give a small kid a freedom to do whatever he wants to do, he will do all the stupid stuff and get into trouble. At the same time, if you try to control a full-grown man and the parents keep saying, do this, do this, do this, as soon as he will get an opportunity, he will separate. He says, I don't want to stay with you because you are not giving me freedom. So we need to balance these two parts. But again, there is no one way. In a 10-people team, there will be different individuals at different stage of responsibility and freedom. You can't behave similarly for all. That, okay, everybody self-organized. There is a team dynamic behavior which also emerges from the team, but the individual also stand at a different stages. So that is something also need to be balanced. Yeah, so go there and then we have a one comment from here and then we move. Yeah, here also, yeah.
Hi, I am Nitendra. So moreover, we were talking about the leadership and stakeholder influence. Although we have experienced and also with my experience, I have seen that to be in competition, leadership pushed organization or team to do agile, but in a waterfall way. So they want to be more competitive. They want to see that, okay, X organization, X builder is doing agile, why we cannot do? So they are accepting agile, but they are not changing their mindset. So doing agile or being agile, that is a major difference where we are failing in this culture.
Thank you. And what I say is, rather than I take an idealistic view, it should not be. Maybe we need to understand, maybe that is the business they are doing. See, let's accept the reality that India is a service country. We work for clients' project. And it may happen, your first project is Scrum, another project is Kanban, and third project is Waterfall. And you don't have a fixed time. Like, unlike a product company, when I become a Scrum Master, I'm a lifelong Scrum Master. Or at least for 4 or 5 years Scrum Master. But the person who is doing, who's working for a service company, and he's a Scrum Master for a one client, maybe next month he's a project manager to another client. And that's a reality, you know. And he might be something else to another client. Because we are in a business where we change process and labels as per the fitment. So again, what I believe is, yes, it's a great awareness, but at the same time, we may also make management also aware of a limitation. That, okay, guys, I understand you want to do iterative and incremental development, but this way of doing will not produce self-organizing team, but it will produce an iterative and incremental development. And in some organization, maybe that is the goal. Like we may not focus on that, okay, people should reach there. So yeah, but again, you may chase for the better thing, but be aware. So we hear the final comment and we close. Yeah, Namita.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Gaurav. I really like your framework of thinking, feeling, and doing. I think one of the things that I probably would add here is thinking, feeling, and emotions.
Okay.
And emotion is nothing but energy in motion. And it starts from leadership and it goes down to the teams. And if the teams are emotionally connected and the energy is flowing well, then it's a little bit easier to get into the rhythm and getting the self-organization.
Perfect. Thank you. I think this is a good. Okay, one more. Yeah, okay. And then we close. Yeah.
Hi. Yeah. Actually, I'm working as a software tester. So at the ground reality, I've seen that means For example, one requirement is there, and it can be developed and test and delivered in 1 year, means number of requirement. But the requirement keep on changing. So how to handle that thing? And due to that, the project gets tested to 2 years, and but no tracking is there. So how to handle such situation? But by the name of Agile, yeah, requirement gets changed, we cannot do anything. But sometimes it gives frustration to developer, to tester. So these things are challenging. I'm feeling that how, but how to address that and how to handle that, that I want to.
Thank you. So I think this is a good closing question related to Agile and how Agile works and how it doesn't work. And incidentally, I was having conversation last week only. The person was primarily focusing on PMP exam, but we had this conversation. And I believe, see, the basic project or a product delivery thing does not change when you change your process. And one of that is working with stakeholders. So many times we suffer because we don't know who are the right stakeholders. And the stakeholder keeps popping up over a period of time. Whatever process you follow, Agile, waterfall, whatever it is, nobody can ensure that you find the stakeholders well. Only you can do it. Or people who are taking care of the project can really do it. So many times you can change, keep changing the process, but the basic essence of identifying and engaging with the stakeholder may get missed. And sometime in the Agile process, people feel that who is responsible for it? Oh, product owner should do it. And again, as soon as we start who, it is again means we are finding someone to blame or transfer the thing. So the essence of Agile way of doing is that you start interacting and owning it. But again, as he said, emotions and all these things, it's not that easy. So not everybody can take benefit from it. Some will take partial benefit. Somebody will just get limited into the process part of it rather than really engaging with the stakeholders.
Really, yeah. At the ground level, I see, I can feel that this thing can be done in 1 year, but it's have taken one and a half year or 2 years, but nobody is seeing that, yeah, but thing is that, yeah, requirement is changing, it's the requirement, but no tracking is there. So if I feel I would be at their position, so I know that, yeah, this is
possible.
The thing.
And what I feel as a project execution as well as a business guy, sometimes the requirements are really out of your control because you really don't have a visibility. So there could be a possibility that visibility is emerging, which was not there. There is a possibility of that there was stakeholder engagement missing and now it is increasing gradually and that's why the requirements are changing. There could be N number of situations. There could be a pure mismanagement also. Nobody looked at the requirement. People came to a sprint review after 6 sprints, and they saw, oh, this is happening. Let's give a new requirement. It could be anything. And solving it is all a team owns it. This is, okay, we need to fix this problem. No process can fix it. As a team, maybe through a retrospective, we decide, okay, let's do something about it, and let's find out why it is happening. Then the change can occur. Till the time we are looking for, okay, some process can solve it, change will not occur. And that is my idea also. You will hear a lot of tracks, a lot of stories. All these stories are great, but they won't change your way of working. And you can't apply them. But they can give you a new thinking pattern, and that thinking pattern can help you to solve the problem. So when you go in a talks, there are multiple talks. You can also talk to the other people. Don't think of that I will get a solution of my problem. Don't even expect that. You won't be able to apply anything which is said by someone else, but it can probably help you to open up a way of a thinking. Then you can definitely feel an emotions about it and probably can solve some of your problem.
Can we have some tool here? The other people are there. So we are using to track the change requirement.
Sure, we can talk. So what we have is we have some separate section where we will have all those conversations. This is a track 4, we are calling it, just where you did a registration. So there are sofas there. So there is a track 4 part in your agenda. There will be a little informal conversation which will keep happening there. So there we can do all these things. Okay, thank you guys for participation and making this talk or conversation fruitful. Thank you.